Hey everyone, I'm Chef Dhruv Roy. Today we are cooking a very classic recipe with a little twist into it, which I'll tell you later. So here we have our risotto, which has been cooked with pumpkin, and we'll be using pumpkin as a main ingredient with this beautiful grains with which we are cooking the risotto. So here are the little things to show you what exactly we're gonna do today. So a very simple ingredients, a very humble one for this beautiful recipe, starting from this black rice from northeastern part of India. Then you have a barley, which is of course locally sourced. This red rice is from south of India, and two different variety of millet. So these will be the five different grain which you're going to use for risotto. Then we have the pumpkin puree or a butternut squash puree. Like as you can see here, we have a butternut squash which has been roasted, and this is a puree of the roasted butternut squash. Fresh herbs, of course, basil and thyme, very, very Italian. Some pumpkin seed for the extra crunch, and some basic seasoning like your white onion, your garlic, and your simple olive oil and wine. So let's start cooking. So your olive oil, not your regular extra virgin, of course. So let the oil be little hot, not too hot. I'm just gonna sweat the onion and garlic. Just be careful that you're not overcooking the garlic and onion. I'm gonna quickly add the onions. So once your onion and garlic is nicely translucent, just add your wine. Be generous with wine, which adds on more flavor to it. Just slow down your heat. Now simply just add your grains. So grains are partially cooked and partially soaked. So you can use whatever grains you have. You can play with just rice, you can play with whatever millets, amaranth, whatever you have. So I'm going to put everything in equal parts. So this barley is like lightly boiled because that takes a lot of time to cook. So is your black rice. This I think I'll add at the end because this is very delicate. So once your rice is nicely sauteed with the onion, garlic and wine mixture, just keep adding your stock. So here I'm using Parmesan stock. You can go with simple vegetable stock, whatever you have. We have enough time for the risotto to cook, so go slow. So once your stock is reduced, add more stock, keep stirring it, and then yeah, your risotto is ready in few minutes. So now this risotto is almost done, like I would say 80%. So we're going to finish this with our fifth grain, which is your foxtail millet, which is also been boiled and yeah, finished because it's very delicate. So we're going to add like 2 spoons of that. A little bit of stock. Keep cooking and keep cooking. Yeah. So your risotto is almost done. So I'm going to finish the whole thing with a spoonful of pumpkin puree. Of course, salt. So we're doing a sea salt here, not your regular iodized salt. Of course, pepper. lot of pepper because we haven't used any chilies in it. So this will give you the heat. Yeah, then we have to scrape some pumpkin to get some extra bite. So yeah. So your risotto is almost done. We're gonna finish the whole thing with Parmesan cheese, fresh basil, and here you go. So your 5-grain risotto is ready with your seasonal pumpkin, which is around the corner. So I'm gonna switch off my pan. I'm gonna grate some Parmesan off the heat. Some fresh basil. And we're gonna finish the whole thing with the surprise which I mentioned before, is your espresso. This is not for me, this is for the risotto. So this will add a little extra kick of bitterness, as pumpkin is sweet. Salty is your Parmesan. And bitter is your espresso. So yeah, so risotto is ready. I'm gonna just plate separately and then that's it. So yeah, let's plate this, the classic risotto from Milan, with our hint of espresso, with our own touch. Thank you. So we're gonna garnish the whole thing with the roasted pumpkin. So here you go, you have a beautiful risotto made out of pumpkin, espresso and some beautiful grains from different part of India, especially for travel, dine, food and drink series. Cheers.